He will get back to us. The attorneys for the detainees are saying their health is deteriorating. We spoke with Pardis Rai. Her client there says he lost 20 pounds since the beginning of the strike at the beginning of February. Pardis said she and a number of other attorneys had sent a letter with their questions to the authorities at Guantanamo, copying the Justice Department. She said they hadn't responded yet.
At this point, the strike is more than 30 days old, and by day 45, we understand from medical experts, there are serious health repercussions that start happening. Things like loss of hearing, potential blindness, and in a couple of weeks, worse than that, ultimately, you know, the potential is there for death as well if hunger strikes continue for weeks. We've received no response to that letter so far.
Parties also said they want a response from the authorities more meaningful than the few remarks by the prison spokesperson in the media. Robert Duran, I mentioned him earlier, responded to the allegations that the prisoners' copies of the Quran had been mistreated, and that's what presumably triggered the strike. He said it was a routine search for contraband and, quote, the Quran is treated with the utmost respect, end of quote. It may very well be so. From the conversations that we had with the lawyers, I got a sense that this act of desperation is not just about the Quran. The lawyers are saying that these detainees desperately want to get the word out about the situation that they're in, not formally accused of anything, not knowing whether they're ever going to see their day in court, detained indefinitely. The UN says holding detainees indefinitely at Guantanamo Bay amounts to torture. 4 years ago, President Obama signed an executive order to stop torture there, but according to the UN, indefinite detention itself is also a form of torture. It's hard to imagine the degree of desperation among the inmates there. Half of them, 86 to be precise, are sitting there with papers from the U.S. government which clear them for release, and yet they're still there. Human rights organizations report hundreds of suicide attempts. At least seven of them were successful. A detainee named Adnan Latif took his own life last September. He was cleared for release by both Bush and Obama administrations, and yet never released. He had spent 11 years at Guantanamo. That gives some idea about the level of hopelessness caused by indefinite detention. So it's somewhat obvious that through this hunger strike, the detainees want to make themselves heard. And it's not easy. We're one of very few channels that covers this story. There's a desire to kind of forget about Guantanamo. It's very much reflected in the mainstream media here and in the scarce reporting that we have seen on the issue. In Washington, I'm going to check in.
Lawyer.